Hi everyone, welcome to the next session of design and drawing of reinforced concrete structure. In last class we have discussed about the design of doubly reinforced beam up to the percentage of tension reinforcement. In today's class we will discuss the design of shear reinforcement, as well as we'll discuss the control of deflection of the doubly reinforced beam. We'll see the reinforcement details for the doubly reinforced beam. Up to now we have calculated about the cross sectional dimension of the doubly reinforced beam, effective span or effective length of the beam. We have calculated the various type of loading condition given in the problem. For that loading condition we have analyzed the shear force and bending moment. Based on that shear force and bending moment, for additional moment we have calculated the percentage of tension reinforcement in the tension zone, as well as percentage of compression reinforcement in the concrete, that is above the neutral axis. We have calculated the minimum tension reinforcement, maximum tension reinforcement. Based on that shear force we have to calculate the percentage of steel will be resist that shear or not, that we have to calculate. And if you see here, this is the percentage of steel and shear strength of the concrete. We are taking it from the table 19 IS 456 2000. For our calculated percentage of tension reinforcement we got the value as 1.77. for that 1.77, how much the concrete will be able to resist the shear stress, that we have to calculate. And based on that table we have calculated the shear strength of the concrete from table number 19. The percentage of tension reinforcement what you are calculated here, it will be directly in the code book from IS 456 2000, table 19. Directly you can take the tau c value, whereas the calculated percentage of tension reinforcement in between the values. In situations you should have to calculate the interpolation of percentage of, that means design of shear strength of the concrete. How we are calculated here means by using the interpolation. Maximum percentage of tension reinforcement for the requirement value in between values we have to take 2 minus 1.75 divided by 2 minus 1.77, highest value minus lowest value divided by highest value for highest value minus required value for the tension reinforcement, as well as for design shear strength, highest value minus lowest value divided by highest value minus calculated shear strength the concrete. From this we have to calculate the strength of the shear strength of the concrete. If you see here, the shear strength of the concrete from table by using the interpolation got the value of 0.7893 mm square, whereas the applied shear force we have calculated based on the loads given in the problem, we are getting this value as 1.61 newton per mm square. If you observe in this condition, the shear strength of the concrete is not exceeding the applied shear force, hence we have to provide the additional reinforcement to resist this shear stresses. If you observe here, in this condition tau v exceeds tau c, because the shear force exceeding the shear strength of the concrete, we have to provide the additional reinforcement. That means this much strength of concrete is already resisting the strength, we have to provide for this additional strength. That means 0.783 newton per mm square is already concrete is resisting. For this additional shear force, that we have to provide the additional reinforcement. When tau v exceeds tau c, we have one more shear reinforcement design. When tau c is less than tau v, we have other shear reinforcement design. Already in singly reinforced beam design, if tau c exceeds tau v, how we have to calculate the shear reinforcement, that already we have calculated. Now we will calculate the shear reinforcement when tau v exceeds tau c. Here by using code book I am writing the class. From IS 456 2000, we are having the one shear reinforcement design, that calculation I am writing here. What is from IS 456 2000, and page number 72 and clause number 40.4. Clause number 40.4. Yeah. From this we have the formula when tau v exceeds tau c given in table 19. When tau v exceeds tau c given in table 19. Shear reinforcement shall be provided as follows from IS-456, page number 72, clause number 40.4. When tau v exceeds tau c given in table, shear reinforcement we have to provide as follows. I am writing here shear reinforcement shall be provided as follows. If you see in your code book, from this code book, page number 72 and 73, design shear strength of the concrete. When tau v exceeds tau c given in table 19, the shear reinforcement shall be provided as follows. That is, for vertical stirrups, we are having the formula Vus equal to 0.87 Fy into Asv into D divided by Sv. This is the formula. We are taking it from the clause number 40.4 and the value as per B. From this we are calculating the shear force value. Well, before calculating this formula, we are having the design shear force of stirrups. Our design of stirrups for the shear reinforcement, that is nothing but we are calculating the design shear reinforcement for stirrups. Vus equal to Vu minus tau c into BD. Vu minus tau c into BD. Where this Vu already we have calculated. Vu minus tau c already we have calculated. That calculated value already we know the formula for tau v equal to Vu divided by B into D. From this, if you want to calculate the Vu, Vu equal to tau v into BD. If you substitute tau v into BD minus tau c into BD, you will get the shear reinforcement for the concrete. As well as, otherwise, if you directly substitute the Vu value, what we are taking it from the concrete, what we are calculated from the application of the loading condition, if you substitute directly also, you will get the shear reinforcement of the concrete. What I am doing here, I am calculating the shear reinforcement for the stirrups. Vus equal to, where Vu already we are calculated, that calculated value Vu equal to Wu into L by 2, or directly you can substitute by tau v into BD, you will get the Vu value. That Vu value we have calculated as 222.32 into 10 power 3. Why? Because 10 power 3 322.32 is the applied shear force already we have calculated. This is tau c, b and d are newton per mm square, hence why we have also calculating substituting this shear force in newton force. That means 222.32 into 10 power 3, where tau c is the design shear strength of the concrete. We are calculated for this percentage of tension reinforcement. Already 0.783 is the design shear strength of the concrete. We have calculated from the table. That is nothing but 0.783, where tau c is the value of 0.783 newton per mm square. And B and D are the width of the beam as well as effective depth of the beam. The width of the beam we have calculated as 230 mm, and effective depth of the beam we have calculated this value as 600 mm. Total depth we have taken it as 650 mm, effective depth we have calculated as 600 mm. If you calculate this additional shear reinforcement design, we have the value of 114.26 kilo newton, 114.26 kilo newton. If you calculate this value, you will get these terms in terms of newton. That newtons by dividing by 1000, if you get this value in terms of kilo newton, that means in newtons you will get this value as 114.269. That directly I am converting newtons into kilo newton. I am getting this shear force, applied shear force as additional shear force as 114.26 kilo newton. That means the tau c will resist the some additional load. Suppose the applied shear force we are having, 100 kilo newton. For this 100 kilo newton applied shear force, tau c will give the some shear strength. That shear strength, it will be suppose 70 kilo newton. 100 kilo newton of application of the shear force, 70 kilo newton of shear strength of the concrete already giving resistance to the applied shear force. The remaining portion, how much amount of force is there? For that force we have to provide the stirrups. How many number of bars we have to provide, as well as how much space we have to provide, which type of legs we have to provide, that we are calculating from this additional shear reinforcement details. This design shear strength, nominal shear strength and maximum shear strength, in third chapter we will discuss very clearly, as well as this is the calculation for design shear reinforcement when the concrete or when the nominal shear strength tau v exceeds the design shear strength of the concrete. From this IS 456, from this class IS 456 2000 page number 72 class 40.4, from this we have to calculate the number of stirrups as well as area of the steel reinforcement for the stirrup, as well as spacing of the stirrups, that we have to calculate. Again I am taking here using 8 mm diameter, using 8 mm dia two legged vertical stirrups. For this resistance, for to resist this additional load, additional shear force, what I am doing means I am providing 8 mm diameter bars as stirrups with two legged vertical stirrup. That is the additional reinforcement I am providing. From this class number 40.4, I want to calculate the shear reinforcement. That shear reinforcement, nothing but we are having the formula VUS equal to, we have the formula of 0.87 into Fy into ASV into D divided by SV, where SV is the spacing of the stirrups. This additional shear force VUS equal to 0.87 into Fy into ASV into D divided by SV, where 0.87 is the value of factor of safety of the steel, already we have calculated in the assumptions. Fy is the yield strength of the steel, that is nothing but grade of steel. ASV is the minimum area of the stirrups reinforcement, that means how many number of diameter of the bar you are using, based on that area of the shear reinforcement you are providing. Where D is the effective depth of the beam and SV is the spacing of stirrups. For to resist this additional load, that means 114.26 kilonewton to resist that load, we have to calculate the spacing of stirrups. How we are calculating this spacing of stirrups means we will calculate here. If you observe in some problems, if you provide the less reinforcement, for less reinforcement the shear strength of the concrete will get less value. If you provide the more reinforcement, the shear strength of the concrete, you will get it more. Okay, from this you will calculate the spacing of the stirrups. I am writing here the spacing of the stirrup, that is spacing of the stirrups SV equal to, we have the 0.87 into, I am bringing this SV value to that side and VUS value to this denominator side, that is nothing but 0.87 into Fy into ASV into D divided by, now I am bringing this VUS value to the denominator side, that is nothing but VU
Yes, if you see here where 0.87 into Fy is the yield strength of the steel, that yield strength of the steel we are taking this value as 415 Newton per Newton square, and ASV is the area of the shear reinforcement. Area of the shear reinforcement. Here we are using the two legged vertical stirrups using 8 mm diameter bar. Hence n into pi by 4 into d square, where n is the number of two legged stirrups. Hence n equal to 2, dia equal to 8. ASV equal to 2 into pi by 4 into diameter of the bar. We are using it as 8 square. Into where d is the effective depth of the beam. That effective depth of the beam, we are taking this value as 600 divided by, if you substitute the VUS, where VUS we got the value as 114.26 kilonewton. Because in top portion numerator we are having the all values in newton and mm. Hence we will substitute this value into newton force. That means 114.26 into 10 power 3. That is spacing of the stirrups. SV equal to, we are getting this spacing of the stirrups as 190.49 mm. Spacing of the stirrups, I am getting this value as 190.49 mm. For this to provide this exact value, I am taking the spacing of the stirrups as 200 mm center to center distance between the individual supports. If you see here the spacing of the stirrups, we have calculated this value as 200 mm center to center. Again from IS 456-2000 we have one more class, that is nothing but spacing of stirrup reinforcement. It should not exceeds the spacing of 0.75 times of the effective depth of the beam. That means the provided spacing for the shear reinforcement you are provided here, the calculated value, it should not be exceeds the 0.75 d. If it is exceeds the 0.75 d, in that situation you have to provide the spacing of the stirrups as 0.75 d. If it is not exceeding the caudal provision value, then you have to use the calculated value as spacing for the stirrup reinforcement. Here I am writing this, the spacing of stirrups SV, it should not be greater than 0.75 times of D, where 0.75 into D is the effective depth of the beam. That effective depth of the beam, we are taking this value as 600 mm. If you calculate 0.75 into 600, we are getting this value as 450 mm. Okay, 450 mm. That means the spacing of the individual stirrups, we have to provide with the 8 mm diameter two legged vertical stirrups up to the spacing of 450 mm. If you observe in our problem, the spacing we are getting only 200 mm. In that situation we have to use this value only. Suppose if it is 450 mm, 420 mm, 500 mm, like that, when exceeds the 450 mm, in that situation we have to use the value of the spacing of stirrups as 450 mm for 8 mm diameter two legged vertical stirrups. Okay, I am writing here provide two legged vertical stirrups with 8 mm diameter bars, with 8 mm dia bars at spacing of 200 mm, at spacing of 200 mm center to center distance. That means for individual stirrups we have to provide this additional reinforcement as 200 mm center to center. If the design shear strength of the concrete is exceeds the nominal shear stress, hence why we have to calculate this VUS equal to VU minus tau c into BD. If it is not exceeding the tau c, then we have the formula for minimum shear reinforcement. That minimum shear reinforcement is nothing but ASV by BSV equal to 0.4 divided by 0.87 into F. By using that class, by using that formula, we have to provide the minimum shear reinforcement to the concrete. In our situation, tau b exceeding tau c, hence why we have to calculate the shear reinforcement like this.
Next, we are having the last step. That last step is nothing but check for deflection control. All these parameters up to now what you are provided, that will satisfy the deflection or not, that we have to calculate. Based on this final step, if it satisfy the, we can directly give this design procedure to the outside. That means for the construction phase, we can give this reinforcement details. But I am writing here step number 17, that is from last step. That step number 7 is nothing but, it is not necessary to write exactly step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4 like that. But the parameters what we have mentioned, that means cross sectional dimensions, effective span, loads, shear force and bending moment, area of the tension reinforcement, minimum area, maximum area, check for shear, okay, all these steps you should have to cover for every design. After that, check for shear, this is control of deflection that we have to calculate. I am writing here step number 7, that is nothing but check for control of deflection, or check for deflection control. For the check for deflection control, we have to calculate the, based on the percentage reduction reinforcement, based on the provision of the area of compression reinforcement, the deflection is within the permissible limit or not, that we have to calculate. From this, already we have calculated the percentage of tension reinforcement as 1.77%, as well as we'll calculate the percentage of compression reinforcement. That percentage of compression reinforcement PSC equal to 100 ASC divided by BD. For PT, we have calculated the 100 ASC divided by BD, we got the value as 1.77%, as well as percentage of compression reinforcement, we will write the formula. That is, percentage of tension reinforcement, we are having the formula 100 ASC divided by B into D, where 100 into ASC is the area of the compression reinforcement, that we got the value as 628 mm, BD and width of the beam, as well as depth of the beam, effective depth of the beam. If you calculate, I got the value of percentage of compression reinforcement as 0.45%. 1.77% you are providing in the top of the beam, sorry, bottom of the beam. 0.45% of reinforcement you are providing in the compression zone of the concrete. From this, we have to calculate the deflection control. If you see here, L by D basic equal to. L by D basic is nothing but the provision of the span to depth ratio. From first class itself, span to depth ratio for simply supported beam, continuous beam, we have considered this value as 20 mm, 20, 26, okay, that like that we have considered the span to depth ratio for the deflection. If you see here, this span to depth ratio for basic, we are having the deflection as 20 mm or 20 mm. From this, we have to calculate whether the provided reinforcement is within the permissible limit or not, that we have to calculate. For this, we have to calculate the FS value. This FS value is the calculated value based on the area of the steel provided, based on the area of the steel required, based on that, as well as the percentage of tension reinforcement, based on the compression reinforcement, based on width to depth of the beam, the deflection we have to calculate. That is nothing but FS equal to, we are having the formula FS equal to 0.58 into Fy into area of the steel required divided by, we are having the formula area of the steel provided. From this, we are having the FS equal to 0.58 into, where Fy is the yield strength of the steel. That yield strength of the steel, we are taking that value as 415 Newton per mm square. Area of the steel required, we have calculated that value as 2279.18 mm square.
divided by provided area of the reinforcement, you got the value as 2453.12. This is the provided reinforcement. From this we have to calculate the Fs value, that Fs equal to 0.58 into 415 into yield strength of the steel. AHT required we have calculated, AHT provided also we have calculated. From this Fs value we are getting this value as 322.36 newton per mm square, 322.36 newton per mm square. From this how we have to calculate the L by D max, that we have to calculate, that I am showing here, that L by D max equal to span to depth ratio. That means L by D max equal to, we are having the maximum deflection, that is nothing but L by D basic into KT into KC into KF, KT into KC into KF, where L by D basic is the minimum deflection may be permissible for the deflection of a beam, KT and KC are the percentage of tension reinforcement, percentage of compression reinforcement. This KF value, ratio of width of the beam to the depth of the beam, that is for flanged beams, that KF value it will come while discussing or analyzing the flanged beam. In those situations we will take this KF value. From this we have to calculate the maximum deflection value, that L by D max equal to, we are having the value of L by D basic, that L by D basic already we have considered from the span to depth ratio from first class itself as 20. And if you see here, from this Fs value we have to calculate the values from the graph, that is from the IS 456 2000. Now I'll show the graph and the percentage of reading of compression reinforcement and the tension reinforcement. And if you see here page number 38, for this table number 38 we are having the modification factor as per percentage of tension reinforcement, as well as modification factor for percentage of compression reinforcement, as well as modification factor for the ratio of web width to the flange width, that we will discuss in a later classes. If you see here, L by D max equal to 20 into KT, percentage of tension reinforcement. If you observe IS 456 4000 and page number 38, from this we have to calculate the percentage of tension reinforcement for the modification factor. If for our calculated value we got the value as 223.6, okay, 223.6, that means 223.6 36 newton per mm square, 223.36 newton per mm square. For this we have to calculate the modification factor for the tension reinforcement. If you observe the percentage of tension reinforcement, you got the value as 1.99. for this 1.99, in between 119 and 240, if you observe, you got the value as 0.99. if you observe in our code book page number 38, for 1.6 and 2.0, in between we have the one value. For this value in between 190 and 240, if you observe, we got the KT value as 0.90. that value we have to take it from the IS 456 page number 38, as well as percentage of compression reinforcement. We are having the one more graph, that percentage of compression reinforcement also we have to calculate the modification factor. For this modification factor, we have the compression reinforcement as 0.45%. already we have calculated this 0.45%. for this 0.45%, if you observe in this graph, corresponding to the modification factor for this touching of graph, if you observe, it is around 1.18 modification factor. That KT value, that KC value, percentage of compression reinforcement value, we are taking this value in nearly between 1.18 mm. and if you see here, this ratio of width to flange we are not considering for the this beam, while discussing the flanger beams, this kf value also, that is in between below the table of modification factor 5, graph of modification factor 5, in flanger beams we will discuss this kf value, that is nothing but the ratio of web width to the flange width. For this modification factor we have to substitute. From this, if you calculate L by D max, that means L by D max equal to 20 into 0.9 into 1.18 into 1, if you substitute, we get this value as 21.24 mm. That means maximum deflection the beam can be get up to the value of deflection as 21.24 mm. That means by provision of all this compression reinforcement, tension reinforcement, the beam can be able to deflect up to 21.24 mm. For that we have to calculate the provided deflection, that means by providing the length of the beam, depth of the beam, how much deflection is coming, that we have to calculate. That means L by D provided, L by D provided, that L by D provided equal to nothing but we are having the L by D provided, length of the span, we are taking this value as 7.23 meters divided by effective depth of the beam, we are getting this value as 0.60 mm. That means if you calculate here, I am 0.60 meters. From this we are getting this value as 12.05. okay, L by D we are getting this value as 12.05. that means the value what you are providing for the deflection control, the provided value will be less than the maximum value. The beam can be able to, sorry, here there are no units. Why? Because in top and bottom both we are taking this as top and bottom both we are taking this value as mm, and so you won't get any measurements here. Okay, from this if you see here, L by D max we are having the 21.24, whereas L by D we are having the 12.05, hence our deflection control is within the limits. Here I am writing here L by D max, L by D max will be greater than L by D provided, L by D provided. Okay, hence deflection is satisfied, hence deflection control is satisfied, hence deflection control is satisfied. Fine. If you see here, the deflection control is satisfied. Otherwise, in some situations, the maximum value it may not exceed the provided value. That means provided value you will get more. In that situation, we are getting more means maybe you are providing less cross-sectional depth to the beam, you are providing less area of the steel to the concrete. In that situations, up to the maximum deflection, the provided deflection, it will make it maximum value for the beam. In that situation, you should have to redesign the beam. Up to now, this is the complete design procedure of doubly reinforced beam. For this doubly reinforced beam, what are the different type of steps we have discussed one by one. Firstly, I will recover, that is cross-sectional dimensions of the beam, effective span of the beam, load calculations, shear force and bending moment calculations. For that shear force and bending moment, we have to calculate the tension reinforcement. For the tension reinforcement, based on the additional moment, we have to calculate the area of the steel reinforcement in the bottom zone, as well as area of the reinforcement in the compression zone. After that, we have to calculate the minimum tension reinforcement, maximum tension reinforcement. After calculation of minimum tension reinforcement, maximum tension reinforcement, we have to calculate the percentage of tension reinforcement. That percentage of tension reinforcement will be suitable for the checked for shear or not, we have calculated. After calculation of checked for shear, we have provided the shear reinforcement. After satisfaction of shear reinforcement, finally the last step is check for deflection control. That means the area of the steel required and the area of the steel provided will satisfy the deflection or not, that we have to check. And after all these parameters, if it is checked by the designer, we will give this design procedure to the practical construction activity. How this is the design is done up to now, up to this. Now we will see the reinforcement details for the discussion what we have done up to now. The reinforcement details we'll see here. Now this is the reinforcement details for the doubly reinforced beam. Up to now, what is the discussion we have seen? We have represented in this diagram. In your examination, they will ask to draw the details of longitudinal reinforcement for the beam as well as cross sectional details for the beam. If you observe here, this is the longitudinal section. In some condition, they will ask to calculate the cross section of the beam also. In that situation, we have to draw the cross section of the beam also. If you see here, this is the longitudinal section. Longitudinal section. Okay. And if you see here, this is the our beam having clear span of 7000 mm, that is clear span of 7 meters, having effective span of 7230 mm, that means 7.23 meters. And in the bottom of the beam, we are provided the 5 number of bars with 25 mm diameter. That spacing also we have to mention. In bottom, we are providing 5 number of bars as main bars with 25 mm diameter. And again, if you in top, we are provided the 2 number of bars with 20 mm diameter to resist the compressive forces additional. And again, these are the vertical members are called as the stirrups. The stirrups also we are provided as the 2 number of 2 legged stirrups with 8 mm diameter as a spacing of 200 mm. That means from this stirrups to this stirrups, we are providing this spacing as 200 mm. The provided shear reinforcement, we are taking this value as 2 legged stirrups. That means for this cross section, we will draw the cross section. I will explain the 2 legged stirrups, 4 legged stirrups or 6 legged stirrups. Already I have shown in video. See, if you observe here, this is the 2 legs. And in cross section, you will observe clearly. And if you see here, this is the total in a 3 dimensional, if you see width of the beam as well as depth of the beam. If you see in this diagram, this is the total depth of the beam. That total depth of the beam, we have considered that value as 650 mm. Total depth of the beam, we have calculated that value as 650 mm. This is the clear cover we are provided to the beam. That clear cover, we have taken that value as 50 mm. That means the reinforcement to the bar, to the surface of the concrete, we have considered both in top face and bottom face. The clear cover we are provided, that clear cover provided is 50 mm. And this is the reinforcement details for the longitudinal section. The same reinforcement details also for cross section you have to provide. For the cross section also, how we are drawing this reinforcement details, I will show here. Okay, if you see here, for this correspondence, you have to, by using drafter, well, in our examination, this is a design and a drawing. Hence why, by using drafter also, you need to draw this reinforcement details in your examination. For a normal nose type, you can directly draw with some permissible limits. Here I am drawing the cross section of the beam. This cross section of the beam, this is the entire total width of the beam as well as total depth of the beam. And if you see here, this is the cover reinforcement we are providing. That cover we are providing the beam as 50 mm. Okay. In top, we are providing the 2 number of bars with 20 mm diameter. This is the 2 bars we are providing. The 2 bars having cross sectional area of 2 bars of 20 mm diameter. In bottom, we are providing the 5 number of bars, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, for this we have to shade this reinforcement bars. In bottom, we are providing the 5 number of bars with 25 mm diameter. Okay, this is the total width of the section, 650 mm. and width of the beam we are taking this value as 230 mm, and the effective cover we are provided as 50 mm. This is the cross section of the beam. Okay, this is the cross section of the beam. These are the reinforcement details up to now for our design of doubly reinforced beam. If you see here, this is the width of the support, this is the width of the support. Width of the support also we are considering this wall as 230 mm. This width of the beam also we are considering this as 230 mm. Up to now this is the complete design procedure for the doubly reinforced beam design. We'll solve one more design procedure based on other type of loading condition as well as for other types of grades of concrete. Up to now, this is the design procedure of doubly reinforced beam. Thank you.